Marseille is the second largest city in France, with a population of over 850,000, and is a vibrant place, which attracts visitors from all over the world each year. A port city situated on the French Riviera in the heart of the Mediterranean, Marseille is steeped in cultural diversity.
This is how Marseille began its year as the European cultural capital.
The Mediterranean city of Marseille is celebrating becoming a capital of culture in its own way, by focusing on the culture of cities.
As residents of Marseille, we're really pleased. We get to see great buildings being built, like this one next to us here. It'll give Marseille a boost, and it needs one.
Unified the city may seem, the divide between the north and the south has never been so great. Voting statistics paint a definitive picture, and the conditions, quality of life, and the general feel are a true reflection of this detachment. Unemployment in Marseille has been consistently higher than the national average since the 90s. And youth unemployment is estimated to be as high as 40%. With a distinct lack of social provisions, living conditions in the northern districts are poor, and an absence of political engagement leaves many without a voice to fight for what they need. Marseille's exciting cultural diversity comes from its long-standing history of immigration. Recent settlers include Greeks and Italians in the 19th century, followed by Russians and Armenians, Vietnamese and Corsicans, and since the Second World War, North Africans. Today, it is estimated that Marseille is home to over 70,000 North African residents. This has helped fuel a growing right-wing ideology in France, leading to the further alienation of many in northern Marseille, particularly within the Muslim community. In 2010, National Front President likened Muslim street prayers in France to the Nazi occupation, sparking widespread condemnation. Many Muslim leaders have blamed Marie Le Pen's fiery rhetoric on Islam and immigration for the rise in Islamic intolerance and xenophobia in France.
Et cette région, si vous voulez, de surcroît, est, il faut le dire, assez exigeante sur le comportement de ceux qui viennent de l'immigration.
National Front propaganda is not afraid to express the party's disdain for North African immigration, and has most recently turned to associating Marseille's increasing crime levels in recent years with the influx of Muslim settlers. This has helped the far right to increase pressure on the government to instate more stringent immigration policies, and as a result, the disparities between Paris and Marseille have widened. This urban strategy proposal takes the radical step of breaking already weakened ties with Paris and creating the new independent state of Marseille, no longer part of the EU, but a new member of the Arab Maghreb Union. A new entrepôt settlement, stimulated by newly invigorated trade, celebrating immigration and cultural diversity. A place which welcomes arrival, provides opportunity, and enables integration. The site sits within the northern districts of Marseille and is typical of the area, a disjointed mix of rundown residential and disused industrial buildings. The proposal continues the existing road through to the water's edge, marking the spine of the scheme. Freeport is introduced, forming a network of new freeports in secondary port cities on the Mediterranean. As worldwide containerization favors the growth of megaports, secondary port cities have been left behind. The new network will reinvigorate these cities and enable them to flourish once again. The introduction of a new fishing industry draws on Marseille's past and provides job opportunities. A new education campus focusing on adult learning as well as public leisure facilities. A new point of arrival is developed, one which provides temporary accommodation for settlers, as well as healthcare and recreation. Enterprise zones providing opportunity to live and work. A framework whereby live-work units can be built as and when required. This allows for expansion over time as the development grows. The close proximity of people within a living and working environment is something commonly found in the Maghreb region, where mutual aims bring communities together. The intention of retaining as much as possible is at the heart of the scheme, and along with the development of gap sites for uses such as religious, governmental, performance, and recreational, the renewal of the existing fabric can begin. A secondary boulevard enables the integration of currently isolated tower block residents. The development of a new transport hub connects the scheme to the rest of the city, enabling future growth. Marseille Melting Pot, 2014.